Okay, my friends, we are back. We're going to share with you a kind of series, the open guard series that I've been working on with Mandy. It's a shin-to-shin guard. So a basic shin-to-shin guard kind of looks like this. We're going to show you three variations. Pretty simple position and very common when somebody gets this knee in the middle, they're trying to pass the guard, okay? We want to address this pretty quickly because she's owning the inside territory, and I need to deal with that. So what I want to do is make a little bit of space, okay? There's a number of ways that you can set this up, but let's say we just start here and she kind of puts her foot in the middle. I'm going to make a little space, and I'm going to put my foot or my shin in front of her shin, okay? Now the next thing I want to do is I want to cut an angle a little bit here, and I'll reach around right underneath of her knee with this arm. Okay, the best situation here is if I can grab this far side sleeve and I can feed it to this hand, okay? This is gonna make this sweep very, very simple. Now what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna come up as high as I can here on her collar. I wanna help break her posture and load her up over top of me, and I'm gonna lean to this side. And as I do that, I'm gonna start extending this leg. So I'm gonna come here and I start stretching. Once she tips over, I'm gonna come up, put the knee there, and try to end up in side control, all right? So let's go over that again. Somehow the guard gets open. I put my shin in front of her shin and I wrap. And I want a constant pressure here. I want to kind of stretch my leg as I'm pulling her into me like this, okay? Now, if I start feeding here like this and she starts breaking that grip, she doesn't like that. She wants to pull that away. It's okay, I'll grab whatever I can. I'll grab the belt. I'll grab the lapel here like this. Whatever I can get, because I need this connection, so when I come here and I start to pull her, she may post, and that's okay. Once she posts, I'm gonna come underneath this arm and I'm gonna take it out. And I continue the sweep, then my knee cuts down and I end up in kind of side control there, all right? Now, another option, sometimes when you get this position here, the person knows what you want. They know that they want, if she starts to come forward with her momentum to try to pass, the sweep is gonna be easy. So they realize that, and sometimes they'll stand up to kind of put some pressure and prevent me from pulling them over top of them. I'll still keep whatever I can get, but when they sit back like that, I'm gonna go with their energy. I'm gonna post my hand on the floor. This is very simple, very basic, stand up and base. My foot's here, now I have base. Immediately, as soon as this foot lands, I'm gonna flip this foot to the outside and kind of drive into her a little bit and pick up that heel. So it's kind of an ankle pick here. So when she's giving pressure here like this, I stood up in base, and now I'm gonna step behind and make that leg light. Once I have it, I pinch my knees here, I keep a hold of the heel, I keep my head tight, and I'm gonna swing this leg back, and I use my downward pressure with my head to take her down where she doesn't have any base. Now I can pass the leg off, and we can end up knee in the belly or passing the guard, whatever. So very simple series. I get a lot of mileage out of that one. There's also a bunch of different variations, triangle setups, different types of sweeps, you name it. But that's a very simple three option series that you can try. Let us know how it works. Like, subscribe, all that good stuff. We'll see y'all soon.